Good evening, my name is Anthony Jennings. Today I would like to talk to you a bit about the master algorithm and its potential impacts on our society. The master algorithm is an idea that was coined by renowned professor Pedro Domingos. He is a highly accomplished individual in the field of machine learning and artificial intelligence, mainly known for his work in the Markov logic network, which is, I suppose, his stab at a master algorithm. The master algorithm, ultimately, is an end goal for all machine learners. It is an algorithm that should be able to solve anything if given enough of the right data. It will be able to model our world and potentially our universe, solve, you know, all problems that we have, world hunger, any diseases, that kind of thing. So what are the benefits for us? With AI comes increased efficiency. Machines don't need to take holiday, they don't need coffee breaks. And so essentially they could work 24/7. AI can compute and find trends in data and then optimize the storage of this data in the cloud or other database services, which would be otherwise impossible to do by humans. This presents many opportunities for us. In medicine, AI and machine learning can help sequence genomes to cure diseases, otherwise impossible to do. They can look at a scan of a human and compare that to millions in its database and then decide what illness a person has. They are also beginning to perform simple surgeries better than a surgeon could with consistency and precision. Of course, the government utilizes AI heavily in technologies such as facial recognition, which helps to ensure security in large events or in general on the streets. AI can facilitate in doing many different kinds of work, and therefore this means for us we could potentially have more time on our hands. We could have more time to do more leisurely activities or focus on other non-academic work. Obviously, if an AI is more efficient than us, able to make more profits for a company without the costs, what role do we have in the labor market? With the progress of AI, it is generally accepted that there will be an increase in unemployment. It's often argued that this massive reliance on AI, or this movement for major AI systems, will cause an event like the Industrial Revolution, where we see massive unemployment, but then ultimately more employment due to new jobs being created. I think, however, this time this is not an argument that can be made, because if this AI is truly the master algorithm, it will undergo iterative recursive processes whereby it teaches itself over and over again to become better at doing something. We have already seen Google create an AI that has managed to create a new AI better than human-made models. And so if an AI can create new algorithms, we don't need to do anything anymore, practically. Because of this, there has been a recent call for universal wage. This scheme involves the government paying people a fixed sum of money each month, regardless of what they already earn or whether they have a job or not. This was tested in Finland, where 2,000 people took part, each receiving about £500 each month. Large names in technology have also, such as Elon Musk and Richard Branson, have also supported the idea, claiming it will be necessary given the rise of automation. However, I feel that this universal wage will ultimately create what's known as a nanny state. People will be disincentivized to work. Perhaps eventually this may lead to us as a species becoming overall less intelligent, depending on AI to survive. Another major consequence of AI, one that we are already facing, is the loss of privacy. Recently, China had installed 7 million cameras with inbuilt AI capabilities. Together, the cameras make a network allowing the government to locate any single person within a matter of minutes. For me, I believe there are two main dangers with this new AI. Instead of putting a reliance on AI and technology, sorry, instead, I think AI, this over-dependence on AI, will make us lazier, less innovative, and less intelligent. Already, with simple autocorrect and grammar checkers on softwares like Microsoft Word, we tend to rely on spell check to indicate whether our sentences are spelled correctly, if the grammar is correct. Imagine what an advanced AI could do. We won't even need to create books or anymore, stories, or write articles. An AI could do that with top grammar and accuracy of information, probably better than a human could. Ultimately, with the end goal master algorithm, we won't need to solve problems anymore. We just feed a problem into the AI and it outputs what it believes to be the solution. And this, I believe, comes to one of the main dangers, which is the misuse of technology. Ultimately, technology is only as harmful as the user's intentions are. AI has the potential to do a lot of good for society. And on the opposite spectrum, it has the capacity to be extremely harmful. AI, in recent years, has been shown to be extremely dangerous if unchecked. In March of 2016, Microsoft launched an AI named Tay on Twitter. Some of you may have heard about this. And within a matter of, I think, 16 hours, maybe even less, of this AI left of its own devices, it had made numerous anti-Semitic attacks on multiple people and expressed support for the Nazi regime. I think this is a very good indicator of why AI is something that should not just be unleashed into the world. It's something that needs to be regulated, has to be checked, and Tay is a very good example of this. So what does this mean for you? Overall, what I hope you take from this is that AI, the machine learning, has the capacity to do good, but it should also be something that you take into deep consideration when using it. You should not have an over-reliance and over-dependence when you use it. It's something that I believe that if we do overly depend on, will lead to us being generally worse off, even though it can solve multiple problems for us.